Welcome back, everybody. You know what this is. It's Q&A with Dr. Jay Dunn, the founder and creator of My Happy Genes, the only genetic testing company that takes into account all of your genes in relation to one another, not just like you have this one gene and you're going to get this one problem. That's not how we roll. Today, we're going to talk about detox. It seems like everywhere you turn, there's an advertisement or an article or something about how important, even for people that feel fine, that we have to be doing these detox programs. And I'm just wondering, A, is it possible that we all need to detox? And B, don't our bodies just naturally detoxify us? We take in a lot of crap. Some of it's leaving our body. So tell us about this detox thing.
Yeah, it's a good topic because you're right. We do detox on a regular basis. Otherwise, we probably wouldn't be around because toxins can kill you and they can shut down biochemical pathways in the body. So if the liver weren't pretty decent at getting rid of toxins and chemicals, we would not survive as a species. However, that being said, toxins today are very different than toxins were for our ancestors. All kinds of new things in our environment, and including the pesticides and chemicals that we put on our body all day, every day, and things that are in our foods, the food additives and dyes and other fun things that we're exposed to on a regular basis. And so it is a very toxic load, and often our bodies are overwhelmed by the amount of detoxification that has to do. That being said, I don't know if you've ever experienced somebody who's impervious to all the toxins in the environment. Other people who are incredibly environmentally sensitive, any little perfume or smell or chemical, and they are crushed by it. I'm somewhere toward that. I have a lot of chemical sensitivities, but I know how to work with my body to get it to detox better. And it isn't like most people think, like, oh, I got to take a bunch of herbs that upregulate or do colonics or do foot baths or those kind of, I call them a little bit aggressive kind of means of forcing your body to detox. It's a matter of understanding how to upregulate the enzymes that are responsible for detox. And they're upregulated by basic nutrients. For instance, there is an enzyme. Can I show my screen?
Please do.
Okay. I want to show you the biochemical pathways for detoxification, and they're down here. And largely it's our liver, but also our kidney is responsible as well. But this enzyme right here, the MT2A, it's a metallothionein molecule or enzyme, and it's responsible for getting heavy metals out of the body. And so if you have a genetic variant there, it can cause toxic metals to build up in your system. But it's a selenium-dependent enzyme. So that's the kind of thing we look at is how do we upregulate that enzyme so that it works better to get heavy metals out of the body? It's not what we normally think of. Oh, selenium for detox. If we know what's going on in the body and how to work with it and turn it on so that it works correctly, then it's easy. We just get the body doing what it's supposed to do naturally. This enzyme right here, the PON, is one of the main enzymes responsible for getting pesticides out of the body. It's a peroxidase. And when you have genetic variants there, it's a good idea not to eat pesticides. Make sure you eat organic. But again, it has a specific nutrient that upregulates it to help us get rid of glyphosates and Roundup and chemicals out of our body. Same with the CYP. That's the cytochrome P450 enzyme, and that's part of a liver detox. That's phase one. And it's upregulated by actually methylation, which we've talked about a little bit. And then these guys, the NAT is an enzyme that gets rid of prescription drugs and smoke and coffee. So people with genetic variants there are not going to detox their prescription drugs as well, and they can get toxic with them very quickly. And they are more sensitive to coffee. So they're going to feel more jittery and very sensitive to cigarette smoke. This guy, the UGT, also detox, and that's phase two, is responsible for getting rid of BPA, and that's in plastics. It detoxes acetaminophen. So people with genetic variants there shouldn't do acetaminophen as a painkiller because it can't be broken down out of the body. And sometimes you'll see high bilirubin with these people. These two also, as we talked about with estrogens, they are involved in estrogen clearance there. And then one of the main detoxification enzymes down here, the sulfur transferase, Again, it gets rid of acetaminophen, breaks down a lot of our hormones. So genetic variants there can cause a buildup of estrogens and some of the other hormones and create problems. So again, we look at what nutrient is going to upregulate that, what's going to turn it on so that it works faster. So it's precise with our nutrients. It isn't like you can take a multivitamin and just make it all work right, because you're going to be upregulating something over here that you don't want to upregulate and not regulating enough over here, or not having the right molecule and the right amount. And so that's the beauty of my happy genes, is where we know these nutrients that your body needs. Oh, you have this gene and this gene. This is your recommendation for what nutrients are best for you and what diet is best for you, because you have these genetic variants. Like the sulfur transferase, it's a detox enzyme, but it also is involved in getting rid of sulfurs. So the people with genetic variants there, not only going to have estrogens build up, but also are going to react to eggs and garlic and onions, and it can cause some really interesting symptoms. These enzymes have multi functions. It's never just one function, but they all have a cofactor that turns it on. It's just fascinating when you know the keys to make that enzyme work correctly.
It really is. And Dr. J always says, don't just go buy the one vitamin that somebody told you if you have this salt gene or this.
Right.
Don't do it because, like you said, and when you say upregulate, you mean you're speeding up something that needs to be at a normal speed. And downregulating means we're slowing it down, right?
Correct. Yeah. And for the most part, when you inherit a genetic variant, it's going to slow that enzyme down because you have the
Okay.
wrong code for it. So it actually does a misshapen kind of thing. And so the cofactor goes in and opens it up so it can work correctly. It's a lock and key kind of thing with enzymes. That's the secret. That's the big secret of what we're doing, is we're turning on those enzymes, turning up the volume on those enzymes so they work correctly, so that you can detox correctly. And some simple, even just minerals and vitamins, to unlock that enzyme, then your body starts to detox all the time correctly without creating all the symptoms of a detox, the headaches and the nausea and the fatigue.
Yeah, I know you're not withholding supplement recommendations. It's just that everybody's different. So you couldn't make one recommendation on, we wouldn't anyway, because that's against the law. But you couldn't recommend one thing to the generic public because we're all different genetically.
Right, we don't know what you've inherited. And so we need to know that pattern. And the software I developed will do that for you. It'll look at, oh, you have these particular genetic variants. These are the right nutrients for you. And this is the right diet and lifestyle recommendations for you.
I don't want to say anything bad about any one specific company, but I have used a couple of other companies in addition to yours just to get a comparison to see what the reports look like. And I have hemochromatosis, which is two genes, one from each parent. It didn't even catch it. And in one of the recommendations, they said I should eat iron-rich foods. Mitosis is iron storage problem. I have never been recommended wrong using your program and your advice based on my genetics. So be careful where you get your genes tested, people.
I agree. I
I'll
agree.
bet you do.
Because I created this company because I saw this happening. I was like, oh my gosh, they are giving wrong information to people and it's hurting them. And it makes me a little irritated when I see that.
Behind the scenes, people, she gets really
Here.
irritated.
It's my MAO gene. There
We
it is.
give her extra supplements to tame that gene. Never, she's like that.
Yeah.
All right, people, thanks for watching. We'll be back with another episode, and we'd love to hear from you if you have something you want to have us talk about. And leave us a comment. How did you feel about this? Did it help? Would you like to share it? We'd love it if you would. Thanks, Dr. J.
Thanks, GC.